This is one of the saddest things I've ever seen. Cop fatally shoots a young man, a father, holding his infant daughter. You heard me. In Seattle, a 24-year-old man, Shaun Fuhr, was shot in the head, by police as he held his infant daughter. This actually happened in April of 2020. The reason why we know about it today is because of a new lawsuit that has been filed. So the young man, Shaun, was holding his one-year-old daughter as he ran through a construction site near Rainier Playfield when he was shot in the head by Officer Noah Zech of the Seattle Police Department SWAT team. This officer is a 15-year veteran of the police force. The police were responding to an assault on a child abduction. I'm going to give you some background to this and some context, okay? The video of the shooting shows the police chasing Fuhr as they order him to stop running. So the 24-year-old complies, but is immediately shot by the police. Did you hear what I just said? He complies, but immediately is shot by the police. The lawsuit also noted that the baby falls to the ground after the officer and another officer approach the 24-year-old father. One officer instructs the other, pick up the one-year-old. A copy of the lawsuit obtained by Atlanta Black Star noted that Shaun Fuhr obeyed the officer's instructions, was unarmed when he was shot. The lawsuit also noted that this young father had enough time to contemplate his death and the harsh reality that he would never see his father or daughter again after the police shot him. He later died at Harborview Medical Center. Let's put up Carmen Best. Carmen Best, now retired, who served as the chief of police of Seattle from 2018 to 2020, claimed that the infant's safety was the police officer's priority, according to Como News. Now, remember, the video clearly shows, and other publications have clearly echoed, that the young man was actually compliant and immediately shot and killed. There's more. The shooting was found to be justified by the Office of Police Accountability after the SPD was criticized for using excessive force. OPA determined that given the totality of the circumstances, and let me explain that. Let me explain what that means. Totality of the circumstances is when they basically say, all right, normally we would say this is wrong. Normally we would say this is illegal. But when we consider the totality of circumstances, let me tell you the circumstance they're considering. He's a black male. They would not have even tried this with a white male or white female carrying an infant, carrying a white infant, who complied. If a white male or white female carrying an infant complied, they would be alive. You know why? Because they would not have wanted to risk the life of the infant. I know many will see this story as a black male, but keep in mind that baby could be dead too. You cannot present an argument to me that you were trying to protect the life of the infant when the father complied and you immediately killed him, while at the same time putting that same infant in absolute danger to die. There's more. Let's put him up. This is your chief, all right? Chief Adrian Diaz is the current head of the Seattle Police Department. At this point, the buck stops with him. We will continue to follow the story. Rickey, what are your thoughts about this, man?
You know what's funny? The fact, even if they fire that police officer, he'll go to one county over and get hired, probably become the police chief. And it seems like people like the man that killed Trayvon Martin, they get they go up the ladder in police. In this particular one that killed Trayvon Martin, whatever his name is, George
Zimmerman.
Zimmerman, he ended up going on a book tour, and he go to places like CPAC and Right Wing. And it's almost like there's no accountability. They won't even change the laws. So the police officer himself, the individual, could be held accountable or get sued. It seems like they're protected. And it seems like when it comes to Black people, their first option is to shoot first. And how can you tell me that you're trying to do what's in the best interest of a child, bringing a baby that close to bullets?